Hey guys, welcome back. Today I'm going to show you how I made this nice singing bowl hammer when using a piece of brass. And I'm going to show you exactly how I did it. I'm going to make a secondary one right here. This brass came off of some candlesticks that I cut apart a long time ago and been using pieces and bits off of it. But one cool thing is I got a great big tripod. I got that in the Philippines recently for $30 US, and I'm going to show you one more tool that I'm going to be using here in just a moment. But I'm hoping that this tripod is tall enough to stand behind the lathe and look down inside of it. So this is the tool I'm talking about. This is all the colors right here. I start with this green and then move my way across. And the foundation is this thread right here from that big haul of thread I got at a Humane Society secondhand store. So stay tuned, I'll be right back and I'll put you over on the lathe. Okay guys, we're over here at the lathe. The first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna touch up this end to make it nice and square and even and clean it up a little bit, take the saw marks out of it. And then I'll go over on the edge right here and put a flat spot so that the jaws will be able to hold it firmly. So I notice that this is not exactly centered in the camera, but I'm going to do the best I can. So okay, put some aluminum down on there. Right about there, just to catch some of the chips and some of the nasty stuff. About 300 RPMs. Now I got to change this tool around. Take me just a second. Bring it over to here. I don't want a quick change tool post. I'm not going to spend money for that. It's just not right for me. At least not now. Well, we'll bring the cutting edge over here. Touch it off, and here we go. Just a little bit more. I'm pretty satisfied with that. Turn this around, put it back into the chuck this direction. Just like this. Okay. See how well that's centered up. Not good enough. Still not quite good enough. Turn the speed down a bit. Okay, now it's running straight and true. This off and tighten these down. Straight enough anyway. What I'm going to do now is just sand the surface, get it nice and clean. myself some 100 grit sandpaper. And some Scotch-Brite. Okay. Take it out, turn it around. We'll do the same thing on the ball end of it. Clean the surfaces nice, kind of break that, round off that flat spot to an extent. Touch it with some Scotch-Brite. All right, so I'm good with that. Aside right here for the moment. We'll get the handle. What do I do with the handle? I'm going to figure it, put it somewhere like a big dummy. All right, I'll be right back. I got to find that.
Okay,
I found the handle. It was right where I left it. Right on. Let's go ahead and put this in here. Okay, bring it up to here a little bit. So now I'm gonna center drill the end, get it prepared for the, this is the end where the brass striker is gonna go. Excuse me for a moment. Okay, turn the speed down a bit. So, go ahead and change this center drill out for a twist drill. I think this twist drill size measured out to be, what was it, 1964ths or something like that one? Yeah, 1964ths. Same diameter as the brass shank. Okay, get you locked into place. All right, so we'll go ahead and so I'm going to go about an inch deep on this. I'm going to mark my drill bit real quick. Sharpie marker. An inch deep. We're looking at right about there. Okay, that's good. I selected a drill that was a little bit slightly larger than this brass shank so that I could put some adhesive on it. So So here we go. Let's get that hole drilled. Give me a moment here. I gotta slide the tailstock a little bit closer. Okay, there we go. And that's basically 1 inch right there. It's gonna squeal a little bit, huh? That's all right. Now I'll go ahead and install a live center into the end of the tailstock. I'll get this out of the way a little bit so I got some room to work. Okay. I'm just going to touch this on the end and get rid of some of the burrs. Slide you out a little bit farther, right about to there. Maybe I should just go ahead and touch up both ends while I'm at it. Just a second here. That's my daughter. She's home from school. So there we are. Turn it around. Bring this into contact with the live end, live center. So what I'll do now I'm just going to come in and put a few kiss marks on here. Just a few little low spots so that the shellac and the thread have got some place to go. Here and there. Yeah, I just got back from the Philippines yesterday, no, 2 days ago, and had a great time there. I got family all over the world, all over in the States and Europe. In the Philippines, and we all finally got to meet together for a big holiday on the island of Mindanao, which was one of the best Christmases I ever had, really. All right. I have to get this guy out of the way. Now comes the messy part. I use shellac to hold all this thread on. I'll show you how I do that. It's one of the reasons why I got this aluminum foil on hand. So I don't want the shellac going all over the ways and the cooling surfaces. I probably should touch that with some sandpaper first. Bring this down to a real slow RPM. I'm using a 1-inch brush and some shellac. I just bought another can of this morning, so this one's almost empty. Right on, so I'm gonna get this nice and wet. Shellac dries pretty quick, fairly quick. And this is the type of shellac that doesn't have any overpowering smell to it. And the first layer of thread I'm going to put on is just this plain white thread. I'm going to have this bouncing around on the floor while I put it on. And so, ready, set, here we go. I'm going to put you over here. I want you tied underneath there. I can increase the RPMs a bit now. During the whole process here, I'm going to have to just keep applying shellac. Just keep on putting more of it on and on and on. Let's go ahead and bring this RPMs down. And bring this over to here. Then we'll go down to about here, and I want to put kind of a bump in the raised area. We'll bring this down to a crawl, more shellac. Yeah, like I said before, I got this tall tripod in the Philippines, and with the dollar to the Philippine peso exchange rate, it cost me 30, 40 bucks for this super tall tripod, man. It was just really quite a score. I'm gonna put another thick layer of shellac on here. Okay, now I'll get my tool set up with all these colored pieces of thread. I'm going to follow along fairly close to the other one that I made the other day, fairly close to its original size, its dimensions relatively close, so that's why I'm going to have this one sitting right here as an example, so I don't brain tard too much. Okay, so here we go. here. This is actually a type of yarn, very thin yarn I bought with along with all the rest of that thread that I got. More shellac on there. And this stuff really absorbs the shellac very nicely, really nice, like that. So we'll get a color band of green going on here. Make sure all the white's covered. It doesn't have to be perfect. It just has to, you know, look nice and fit my hand nicely with a little bit of grip. Okay, I'm gonna call that color done. Put you around here. Bring you up to there. Put it there. Put that there. Now the next color is yellow. And here we go. Put a little tension on it. The edge of here, and we're going to go back to the other end. And put a stop to it. Get this yellow yarn out of the way. And you guessed it, more shellac. I tried different things like super glue and stuff, but I found this shellac works really the very best. It's nice. It doesn't smell bad. It dries pretty quick. I like it. I prefer it really. So now comes color blue. Now I'm going to put a lot of extra blue on because I want to have a hand bump right in here. Going to build up a bit of a hand bump right in there. This way I can rest this hand bump in the palm of my hand and use it to just gently, you know, just ding, ding, ding like that, just very gently strike the singing bowls. Bring you out here a little bit.
little bit more, a little bit more.
More shellac. And we'll shellac your ass down to here. Okay. So next comes the pretty messy part where I'm going to glue the brass end into here. I usually get quite a bit of that glue and shellac on my fingers. So I'll move you out of the way. Just a minute, I'll be right back. Yeah, I had to store this E6000 in the house to keep it warm. Because it's really not very warm out here in this shop. And that's one thing that kind of stifles some of my artworks, is that it's hard to paint anything or glue anything this time of year because it's just not very warm. All right, so with that said, I'm going to bring this over here. Give us about an inch of glue on here. Somewhere in there. And we'll put these two pieces together. Okay. We'll replace you back in the tool. Okay. And a bit more shellac on the glue. So what I'll do here is I'll start making a taper from here upwards into here with red thread. This red thread is just normal thread. It's like nylon or whatever it is. You can buy it in a local supermarket or whatever. So let's bring you around like that. I'm just going to go ahead and thread this right over the glue. Let's get this tail end over here and place you in and under this. There we go. Okay, let's get after it. Turn the speed down, I'm starting to lose control of it. I'm going to start right about there, since I had a happy little accident and put my thread on there. Some more shellac on.
all of this. I'm going to start building this up into a taper, like I said before. This takes a little bit of time. Pile up that much red thread. Back and forth we go. Okay, so that's starting to look a little bit dry. Now, this taper is not necessary, but it just finishes the job. Shellac. As soon as the thread starts looking dry, put some more shellac on. Again. None of this is really necessary. I could use these little brass striker, even as it is, it'll work just fine. But why not dress it up a little bit? Make it look kind of cool, good grip, fit my hand a little bit better. So that is the end of this project. Let me go ahead and roll this up. So, This project's pretty much done. This over here was just a little bit of an accident, but I can live with it. So all I have to do now is basically, when I can, I'll bring it into the house and get it warm and allow it to sit there and dry. So put one more coat all the way across it, just for extra measure. Makes me feel better knowing that it won't unwind. And with that extra coat, let's go in the house and test it out. Okay, got them both done now. Let's test them out a little bit. Thanks for watching. See you again.